Take 67. To be honest, I never felt comfortable enough to do a large portion of my video with me talking. And the reason being is I did not make any footage from my last holiday trip. So I have my cheat paper on here. And on this episode, I want to talk about none other than the Ricoh GR. The one I have is Ricoh GR 1. One as the first generation of the Ricoh GR with APS-C sensor. Last week, I went for a holiday with my family. At the beginning, I wasn't even considering to bring any camera, but luckily I did bring my Ricoh GR. So on this video, I want to share my take on Ricoh GR as using it for travel photography or holiday photography or whatsoever you want to call it. So let's get on with it. Here are my 5 takes on Ricoh GR as a travel holiday camera. The first one is size. It's very compact. It's a pocketable camera. You can easily put it in your jacket pocket. It also fits very well on my cargo shorts on the holiday. It's also the weight is very, very light. I ended up never put the GR on my pocket and just leave it hanging on my wrist. Anytime I need to take a pictures, I know the camera is always there. So number 2 comes to control. We were traveling back when it was the peak of a heat wave in Italy. I have my both hands very much busy. It's either I have to find direction with my Google Maps or just keeping ourselves hydrated with bottles of water. Having the camera easily handled with one hand is a great benefit. I can just switch between aperture and shutter speed easily with my... It's only about the muscle memory of my index finger and my thumb. So the third one is settings. My personal setting was I put it on TAF mode. Since we were traveling on the heat of summer, like I mentioned, outside is very, very bright, while once you step inside those beautiful churches, it gets very dark, it gets very dim beautifully. I feel more easy for me to set with my index finger to switch between the aperture, so I can just flick to F8. Beautiful summer it is. Okay. So help me to subscribe and like this video. Hopefully I can hit like 1 million subscriber. I can buy one of those red cars. Okay, so going back to the settings, I put the camera on autofocus because I don't want to be bothered with remembering the snap focus on which distance I'm setting my camera. Comes to the fourth is about the sensor size. It is a small camera, as we know it has the APS-C sensor. At the beginning, I was very doubtful that every time I get inside the churches and I need to take some pictures, I might have to switch back to my phone or borrowing my wife's Samsung phone with those HDR making everything bright. Yikes! Thankfully, I don't have to do that. The APS-C sensor, even on the Ricoh GR, the first generation, it's good enough. And since I'm not printing any of these pictures, I even left it the ISO pushed all the way to, I think, 3200, somewhere around there. And the last one is the best part of having Ricoh GR for travel and holiday photography. I mean, like, I saw a lot of people with a much better, bigger camera with the big lens, and okay, I know, I'm sure they will take a better resolution pictures and ended up with much more usable pictures. But I still get that, I mean, like, either a jealousy or approval nod. I can't imagine how suffering when you have to handle a full frame heavyweight camera in the middle of 40 degrees summer. Okay, so like I've told you before in the beginning, it's not easy for me to do this talking head video. Hopefully, I will see you again very soon, back with the photo walk video around Milan, which I don't have to do a lot of talking head like this. And I hope you enjoyed the rest of the summer. I will see you again on the next one. Saya Ibnu Fajar. Ciao.